Every real dude got theme music. Y'all go trip when y'all hear my theme music, cause I'm about to get in a little bit of topics. You know what I'm saying? But I'm coming to my theme music. I don't think they can do that. Make it your own girl too, homie. Cause we fly over here.
DJ Gemini.
Right.
Spotting me a tender thing, baby. There you are, come on, baby. Don't you want looking for me?
Alright.
Can't get hand to hand me.
You got it.
Too much better.
You wanna
dance with me tonight? Gotta put your tender.
You wanna
dance with me tonight?
Yo. Yeah. Nah, but for real. What up? Nah, I just wanna say something, you know. I wanna get a few things off my chest, right? You know. First off, I wanna start off with you know. You ever have a woman? All men. This is the men right here. Coming from a man, you ever have a woman you stayed the night with, but you didn't get none? But you didn't get mad neither. I guess it made you feel classier, you know? You start realizing, hey, maybe the finer things bringing happiness, you know, can come in ways that confuse our hormones as men after puberty. You don't even care if your friends play you talking about you ain't smashed yet, you sprung, blah, blah. I was once handed a Bible by a woman. I didn't accept it and look like to the woman, you're pretty, you're smart, you're tough as I am. Why are you handing me this book? I guess they never realize sometimes you really telling them they're different in a good way than your usual type of female you're attracted to. It confuses you. You always ask, why does she lower her higher standards? She inspired me to become, you know, for those she adored. So, you know, why do women lower their standards for those they adore rather than keep them as high as the men they inspire to have high standards? Like if a woman tells you, you need to be patient in getting in the sheets with her. Why does she let another guy who doesn't have as much patience get in the sheets with her? You know? Another thing, I never got when dudes rock the mean mug and pictures. The ice girls, you know what I mean? The growls and all that. The mean face. Because I say, people gonna hate you regardless. You look mean or you don't. Yeah, you know what I mean? You just have to decide which fights are worth fighting, and if any fights are worth fighting at all. You might as well throw on some hot, trendy clothes, you know, in this lifetime, though, while you're at it. Because looking tough and dressing all bummy, it's not gonna keep the haters off of you. Even if you're the only person that think your clothes is hot or they fly, you know, still, you know, express yourself, you know, have a good time. You feel comfortable about wearing your, you know, how you feel. Dress how you want to dress. Don't let nobody dress you up. You know what I mean? Parents don't buy our clothes no more. We grown. Come on. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of family on Facebook. It's real. I love the family that care when they signed off of Facebook. You know, I don't need a photo op for every family moment. So, you know, a lot of family don't make it on Facebook. And, you know, we probably got more love for each other staying off of Facebook than on. So, you know, had a good time this weekend. You know, sometimes I miss family gatherings. You know, I'm a younger generation than a lot of my family is. So, usually my parent is the one that cares more about the family functions and, you know, to stay in tune with her generation, because generations don't go by age. So I really can't say nothing about this past weekend if the certain events aren't important to everyone, but honestly, I'm going to strongly make a commitment to not judge any family, whether they're blood related or they're not blood related. I'm not going to welcome all family, but if you could take a moment to witness enjoying the moment around me off of Facebook, you cool with me and my book, all that other stuff. You know, everybody else trying to, you know, I guess win the best judgment or award on Facebook or something, you know, look like you really care or something on Facebook, you can go ahead with that. You can keep that on Facebook. You can do your thing. You know, you can get away from me. Yeah, I mean, I don't need that. Yeah, too many cameras, you know. What was I at? I think about a lot of people I see in Harrisburg, PA, doing this music, this hip-hop thing. What I think about them, some of them not from the hood. No, not everybody grew up in the same type of struggle, situation, environment, community. What I think about them, I think they cool. I can't really identify a person who lost anything in life to wish that feeling upon another that it was sheltered from it. I think maybe their parents were very wealthy, which made them never understand the struggles and sacrifices have nothing to do with intimidating expressions of self. You know, mean mugging and ice grilling. That ain't really, you know, that has nothing to do with the struggle, sacrifices, you know. Nor do you hit the gym, lift weights to look tougher on the outside than within your soul. Definitions of muscle do not define patience endured by someone committed to surviving all obstacles of life. You know, having patience to wake up every day and, you know, be ready to encounter any type of obstacle thrown their way. I don't really get jealous of others doing as well or better than I am financially. That's a game of the hearts. Too much emotion, you know, that conflicts interest. So what if the woman I'm attracted to the most feels I'm worth less than another displaying more about them than I? You know, maybe they're just more emotional, they share more, maybe they, you know, they feel more inside, you know, to express to a woman. That's on them. I feel my materials and my lifestyle should be held to a higher class than those not patient to witness time as it happens. So no, everyone's not gonna get a full my life story. No, I'm not gonna do that. I don't do that. I don't get jealous, honestly. I just say I don't know the person personally to have any emotion of what kind of person they are. Maybe they have more money than I. Maybe they have less money than I. Maybe we have the same amount of money. That's not something that would influence me to meet a person anyway. So, yeah, I welcome everyone. And I say black power is cool, but if you don't approve of brown skin having good credit, you can go stand in a black room complaining about your bills without me, because I'm going to pay my bills. I'm not an Uncle Tom. It's just black history is history for a reason. There's not going to be any black present nor black future. We have credit now, which we need to pay on time, like all other colors who aren't part of our history. And I'm not black, I'm brown. So, you know what I mean? Respect my color. Whether some give me credit for it or not, I have elders that I'm pretty sure would say, I hope you don't celebrate our history by being a radical and not appreciating the opportunities establishing more credit than they have. I pay my respect through my bills to my ancestors and my elders. That's what they taught me. They gave me patience, you know? A lot of patience they didn't have. They didn't have that chance, you know? I guess some black history and ancestry, you know, they fought and worked so much. They had no choice but to be radical for that opportunity we have presently. It's not up to history to determine our future. Only impatience expects the past to determine the future. I know the history I come from work so much so I can have more patience to maintain and survive, enjoy myself. So, you know, I'm gonna do it. If I put popularity and sex appeal before my music, my art, my culture, I don't think so many unpopular would catch the wave of the crowd. I guess I'll just have an unpopular fan base. I love it anyway. We can be unpopular together. No funny stuff, you know, no touchy-touchy Philly, all that, but, you know, we'd be unpopular together. PMS 87, Porter Max Shreds. You know what I mean? Shout out Thomas Handsome, Dumb Up Stupid. They show me a lot of love. Fleet DJs mixtapes. They doing their thing out there. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm sorry, but I need to know. Who decided to make camo shorts in Joe Dirt jean vest and style? Plus, what up with the girls with the do-it-yourself nails with the claws? It's like, they real sharp at the edge. They look like cat claws, you know? I'm like, next thing you know, people who gonna be attaching motors to stolen grocery store carts. And they gonna be riding around in a stolen cart. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man. That's not cool, you know? People tell me the camo shorts and the jean vest is in style. Women with the do-it-yourself claws on their nails is sexy. These people look like they live by Williams Grove Speedway. You know, y'all know Williams Grove with the roller coaster, with the truck ran through the roller coaster. You know Williams Grove. Come on. You know when the wealthy people see this, you know, they gonna see the not wealthy people doing what they do, and they gonna get mad and go right back to Fifth Avenue, go all uppity and proper. Everything French, mani-pedi, women, you know, everything, you know. They're going to raise the prices on everything. They already stopped buying Maybachs. You got to be on a list now to drive the car. They drive, you know. If you ain't in the club, you ain't getting the car. So it don't matter how much money you got. So when I see dudes fall down to that fashion trend stuff, that just tells me you have no self-esteem to match your own clothes. It's like your parents still pick your clothes out when you go shopping. Come on, man. You know, that's like I wear 580 New Balance sneakers. You know, people was looking at me like, if you don't stop wearing them lame-ass kicks. I'm like, you know how much cushion on my feet? You wildin', and I'm matching. My shoes is matching. I don't care if ain't nobody else wearing these, you know? My thing is, I play the role a lot of the friend that catches the favorite friend hating on the friend in common we have with the baddest girlfriend. Problem is, money makes the friend in common's imagination choose their favorite friend over me, the friend, in, you know, their friend in common. And they choose their favorite friend over their girlfriend as well. So they end up lonely together. And usually, they lost a good girl and a good friend that was never around them for the money. The main point about this, what I want to say is, personally, you know, I know, you know, without a lot of the money, a lot of the high-priced fashions I buy, without the chain, you know, without the nice foreign car, and, you know, without living in a nice house, the high quality, you know, the nice, high expensive food I eat, you know, I like my steak, you know, I like the 12-ounce. Sirloin, I don't like no fat, you know, it gotta be good, you know, I like everything kind of top of the line. I drink DOCG wine, I don't drink regular Moscato, I drink Moscato d'Asti, you know, the dessert wine, you know, a little bit of carbonation, the sweeter, you know, get a little bubbly, get a little fizz in you quicker, you know, that's me, that's my style. I know without a lot of this, it wouldn't be sexy to a lot of women. I'm not a guy, I'm honestly tell, like I hang around a lot of dudes that like the nice things I like. When I look at my friends, if my homie ever said, how I look, yo, I would honestly tell my real homie, yo, your gear is tight, you fresh to death, but you ugly as my nigga. You feel me? You ugly as... You feel me? I mean, I look in the mirror and I say, man, if I have all this fly stuff, I'd be ugly as... You feel me? So yeah, you ugly, but you my dude and you dress fresh to death. And I'm fresh, we dress fresh, but we both ugly as... Because we dudes. You feel me? I don't think none of my homies is cute. Like, my male homies, like, when I introduce them to women I know, I don't think they cute, so I ain't gonna tell a girl, my homie cute. You feel me? You need to hide my... I'm gonna tell a girl straight up, my homie ugly as, but he got money, and he fly as, so, you know, he might put you on, so he might step your game up a little bit, and she be like, yeah, okay, I like that. So, you feel me? So, when my homies trip, You know, when I see a good girl from one of my homies, you gotta understand, I think all my homies is ugly. So when I see a girl that like my homie, whether he got money or he don't got money, you feel me? I think that's a good girl because she think he cute. And I think he ugly as, you feel me? It's got better when he got money and he got nice clothes and he got nice gear and nice cars and stuff. But before he had all that nice stuff, he was ugly. He was just ugly. Now he got all the expensive, you know, he has all the pretty materialistic things, but he's still ugly as, you feel me? And if girly was there before you had all that, she liked you when you was ugly, so you need to keep her because she thinks you're cute. And I don't think you're cute. But I keep it real with all my folk, with all my homies, my male homies. Yeah, I don't do that. You feel me? Like, I don't trip over girls. Like, you know, some of my homies, they got friends. They got other male friends that honestly look in the mirror and say, I'm cute. I'd be like, well, y'all both ugly as, and y'all just let this pretty girl dip out because y'all, both of y'all ugly as, you feel me? And I don't do that. I'm not a hater. I just think all my niggas is ugly as. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is. I'm serious. Like, so no, you don't gotta worry about me hating. Not at all. You know what I mean? That's just me, you know what I'm saying? So, I'm not a hater. I just would like to see a lot of my homies that's ugliest with women that think they cute. Because, honestly, as a man, I'm not going to tell my homie he's cute. I'm going to say, you know, you dress fly, you dress fresh to death, you got some money, you doing your thing, but you need to roll with her over there because she think you cute and I think you ugliest, so roll with her. You know what I mean? Homies shouldn't even come in between men and their girls. Like, I don't even do that brother and sister. I don't do that Drake Marvin's room. I don't do that. Like, if chicky chick about to get married to somebody and she happy, and somebody make her happy, more happy than I can make her, you need to go with him, girl. That's what I am. I mean, I'm straight up. Like, I don't do that. I don't do that though. That's me. Young homie. You know what I'm saying? I wonder if the end of the dove take triple A. You know? Yo, it's my jaw. Hold on. I love it.
Hey, yo.